So here we are at day three. Water's gone down probably about a meter. There's still probably about a good meter to go. One of the local survivors.
Welcome back to Doc's Hot Shop and Forge. So today I'm going to continue what I started before the floods, and that is to forge out the Viking sword blade. So at the moment we've got the three billets and we're getting ready to weld them up into the one piece. Grind some of the scale off and see how bad the fish lipping is. Width-wise, when we started grinding, they were just shy of 50 millimetres. We've lost about 4 millimetres. So, what we'll do is, we'll tack it in a few places, bring it up to heat, forge it down so it tightens up. And whilst we're doing that, we'll have it heavily fluxed. And then once it's welded, we start drawing it out. Actually, before we start drawing it out, we might do the fish mouth and bring the tips in. Just so that we can close this out as soon as possible. Anyway, let's get this set up for welding. And then we'll give it away and see how much we've lost. That weld did not do very well.
hotter. Alright, that's more like it. Do the bit in the middle, and then lastly we'll do the tip, and then we'll repeat going backwards and forwards a little bit, and hopefully after three or four heats we've got it sufficiently welded that we can start drawing it out. Number three, so we'll start at the tang end and then work our way forwards. So far. so we can even out some of this. Mouth out so we can forge weld the tip closed before we get too much further into the project. Oh yeah, so we don't forget. I'm getting used to a new angle grinder, which is a bit annoying. Can't see any sign of the seam for that join. That is pretty good. Let's get that hot, close that up. We need to. Love that. Make sure we have a nice clean bird mouth. Very, very tip. pretty good. All right, let's get back to drawing this thing out. Bit of a centre line set up, then I'll go back to the start. We'll just start working backwards and forwards, straightening it as we go. But it's getting that centre line set up that's the important bit. And this is actually allowing me to get it pretty close, pretty quick. Vicinity of 15 centimetres. I was aiming for 10, so bonus time. And we have yet to forge in the bevels on the point, which we're going to do in a minute. We're just tidying up the fuller, just getting rid of most of the fullering marks therein. We won't get the edge quite as thin as we'd hope, but that's okay, because grinding away a little bit more actually reveals a better pattern, so it's all good.
So that's where I'm going to leave off. In the end we ended up with a total blade length of 1 meter, which includes the tang, so overall 850 millimeters, or just shy of 3 feet of cutting edge. We've got to get started on the grinding next, but that's another video. So if you've enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up, feel free to share on social media, and if you haven't already subscribed, I'd love it if you hit that subscribe button. When you do, don't forget, ring the notification bell. So get out of your shop, have some fun, push your envelope a little bit, but above all, stay safe, and I'll catch you for the next one.